Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to send image as an input to OpenAI API and make it to analyze and ask any questions from it. So let's get started. Before that, if you want to watch the entire tutorial I did on how to use OpenAI API with Python, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. I would have explained it in a much more brief way. So here at the moment I'm having a simplest of Python codes that connects with OpenAI API. Here I'm having the API key and I've imported the OpenAI package. I'm specifying the model name and I'm giving the input. So we are consoling the response.output text. And this is the response that I get. So now let's see how we can add image input. And the boilerplate code for this is already present in OpenAI API documentation. So just Google OpenAI API and click the first link. And we'll be taken to docs over here. To the left, we'll be having quick start. Click it. And if you scroll down, we'll be having the analyze image input. Just change this to Python. And here we are having a sample code, how we can add image as an input. So here in this example, they have given image URL as the input over here. So we can even like reuse this code. So I'll just quickly copy this. And we don't need this. I need the API key, so I'll just paste it over here. So we're having a quite similar code. The only difference happens in the input. So inside the input, we are actually passing two JSON. One is the prompt that we want to ask from that particular image. So this comes from the user, which is us. And in the content, we are sending what teams are playing in this image. So this image could be like related to some sports. And next, in the content, we are sending the image itself. So for that, we are having the type, which is the input image, and we are having the image URL also specified. So let me just change the link and let me go with another prompt. So here I'm having the image of Paris. So let me just copy the link of it and let me just go here. So we need to just replace this particular image URL. You can have it in a generic way in case if you're going to get the image URL as the input. So that's it. And my prompt is going to be, what is the name of the river? Okay, this is going to be my prompt, and let's see if it's able to detect it. And the model, let me go with GPT 4.1, quite advanced model, and it's going to be Python, the file name.py. And as you can see, it has got the output spot on. The river in this image is the Seine River, which flows through the city of Paris, France. And the Eiffel Tower is also visible in the background. That's spot on from OpenAI. And now, in case if you want to also input images directly rather than giving it as a URL, here at the top we are having computer vision. Click it and this will take us to images and vision. Under this we are given two options. One is create images and another one is process input images. So create images means basically we can generate images from a prompt, which is text to image generation, and we can input images and edit them. So I have done an entire tutorial on those also. You can just click on the card and check it, how to create images in OpenAI API. We are more interested in processing input images. So for this, here we can scroll down. We will be having analyze images. And here we are having three ways how you can do this. One is passing a URL, which is the way we tried out earlier. And next, passing a Base64 encoded image. So this is the way where we can directly input the image. As you can see, they are just reading a particular image from our local directory and sending it as a Base64 image. So this is the format that it accepts. And if you scroll down, here we are having some image input requirements. So these are the types that it can support. There is some size limit also and other requirements. Of course, these aren't allowed. Cost calculation. So you can just read it through. This is in depth of everything. So now let's see with this code, like sending a Base64 image. So after copying that Base64 code, also make sure that you have imported this and you retain the existing OpenAI API key. And here I'm having my image, which is wheels.png, just a crazy AI image with a lot of wheels. And we need to make a couple of changes over here. In the existing one, we need to change the image path. Here we need to specify our file name with the extension. So wheels.png. And since I am having the image in the same directory as the Python file, I don't have to specify here the full path. And here we need to specify the MIME type also. So here we are having the JPEG. We need to specify here it as PNG. And now we need to change the question. So we can just have how many wheels in this image. Okay, for running, it's the same command, Python your file name dot py. So I'm not exactly sure how many wheels are there. And yeah, it has given a number. It says 21 wheels. So let's just go with that. And we are also having other ways, like using the file API. You can even use it using that file ID. And apart from that, you can just read it through the limitations and the cost. You can just try playing around with it. And in case if you want to send this image from API, like from the postman, you can simply copy this entire code and you can just ask ChatGPT to create a REST endpoint using Flask library, and it will also give you a sample request. So literally you can just copy paste the code and it can generate that code for you. It's simple. That's a video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. There are a lot of videos in AI tools, OpenAI, Gemini AI, API, and other coding stuff. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.